Good morning, friends. You may be aware of the extrajudicial killings or police encounters or lockup deaths and also handling of the prisoners with the handcuffs, all these things which are deprecated by the high courts, even by the legal fraternity also. Very recently, Mr. Narendra Kumar Garg, of course, and he is represented by his advocate Jitendra Arunyam Sharma. They filed a petition before the Honorable Supreme Court raising concerns over the extrajudicial killings and handcuffing of prisoners, and their intention is to prevent the same so-called extrajudicial killings and what measures have to be taken. Incidentally, this matter has come before the none other than Chief Justice of India, Sharad Arvind Bobade. So, immediately after seeing the petition, he retorted, "Where are you going with this petition?" He asked Advocate Sharma, "Where are you going with this petition?" Right? So, then how can we prevent the extrajudicial killings? And how can you say that the accused should not be handcuffed? What about the dangerous criminals? He asked put the question. Now, the matter started. Right, senior advocate Jitendra Sharma, he cited this case of Citizens for Democracy versus State of Assam. And also, he has cited the old case, Prem Shankar Shukla versus Delhi Administration 1980, where, so he stated that the accused should not be ill-treated, they should be treated in humane conditions, there should be no cruel treatment for them, they should not be treated, they should be treated with human dignity, all these things he has stated as per that thing. Prem Shankar Shukla case says about they should not be handcuffed unnecessarily, all these things he has disclosed, right? So, then the CJI asked for his suggestions also. So, how to stop the extrajudicial killings and how to stop the illegal handcuffing of the police. Here we are focusing on the handcuffing also, right? So, he may be in that connection. He stated that it is better if the accused is, the statement of the accused is recorded by a judicial magistrate at the time of remand, whether he wants to be handcuffed or not, whether the police have handcuffed him or not. Two points he has asked. So, then the CJ immediately intervened. So, Mr. Sharma, do you know which fellow will ask that he can be handcuffed? Which fellow will admit or will be ready for the suggestion of being handcuffed? Everybody will say, "I should not be handcuffed." But normally, the fellows who want, definitely criminals who, the normal criminals, they say that they don't want to be handcuffed. We came to know the incidents of the killing of police persons by criminals. We know that the Tihar jail, they have killed the jail warden also. So how can you assure that he should not be handcuffed? So according to Prem Shankar Shukla case. So there are certain people nowadays, gone are the olden days. Nowadays people are resorting to this also. So such fellows should be handcuffed. This is the obiter dicta. Right? CJ says some accused are dangerous. They must be handcuffed. The accused is the best person to make known such apprehensions. But why should he, the magistrate, record such apprehension? The magistrate, can he ask, do you want to be handcuffed? It is not not at all necessary. As regards the extrajudicial killings also, right, he said that the Protection of Civil Liberties Committee versus the State of AP versus the Union of India, so many cases he has cited. Not all. Extrajudicial killings, definitely they should be stopped, but the direction should be given. Already we have given so many instructions to be implemented by the police. But the police should act in letter and spirit. There should be no third degree method. They should not use third degree methods. They must use the latest sophisticated scientific methods. Like so many things are there, lie detector, all these things. So they should go that. But if they don't follow it in letter and spirit, these extrajudicial killings will be definitely going on. And we can't stop. We cannot put a full stop for them. Here we are there only to give directions. Right? So when the Mr. Sharma, senior advocate, stated that the magistrate can ask the accused, do you want to be handcuffed? Immediately his reply is, this is obiter dicta. I may be obiter than actions, only verbal expression, incidental remark. No, no. Which accuser says that he should be handcuffed? If the accused wants to assault the police, definitely he could say no. So any accuser, would he be so foolish that to say handcuff me? Is it not really? So people kill the police, people kill jail wardens also. So advocate says, yes, Your Honor, I do agree, but there must be some procedure regarding non-handicapped. For that he already stated that we have already given instructions in so many cases that only dangerous criminals should be handcuffed, that too with the permission of the court already. So we cannot entertain this petition. Petition is dismissed. So why I am telling all these things is because previously we ourselves told you that the accused, there are instructions in Prem Shankar Shukla, M.H. Hoskote, all these cases, citing all of them, that the accused should not be handcuffed. At the same time, I told you, I don't know whether you remember or not, if the accused are dangerous, deadhead criminals like our Stotupuram boys, then or Munna Bhai, then what you have to do, you have to apprise the court about the apprehension that he may try to escape, he may attack the police, there is no safety for the police. Then if the honorable court gives permission, yes, you can handcuff him. Otherwise, right to handcuffing is against the right to life and liberty. Article, of course, Article 21 they have stated. So that's why now the reverse trend is also going on. The practical reality they are actually observing. The CJ observed the practical reality. That he stated that no, 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 which fool will say that to handcuff me? And which fool will say don't handcuff me? Everybody will say don't handcuff me, because it is a social stigma. If they come out of the court with the handcuffs, it is a stigma. We have seen people, that's why when they are handcuffed also, normally what they do is, the escort man will carry his weapon like this and he is moving on, and this man will actually wrap a towel around the handcuffs and he will also be doing, we don't know where they are going, of course they will go to jail only, it's a different thing. But they cover it like that also. But anyway, now it is in the eyes of the Supreme Court that dangerous fellows should be handcuffed. This is what I want to tell you. Thank you very much.